A large battery fire disables a cable car system, leaving 400 people stranded on Table Mountain. On October 24, 2024, at 1 p.m., there was a fire at Cape Town's Table Mountain Aerial Cableway. It stranded hundreds of visitors on top of the mountain. The source? It was a battery system, a battery energy storage system. It was designed to back up the power for the facility. Originally, they installed this to improve reliability, but that didn't quite work out as planned. This video is sponsored by Blaze Stack Fire Investigation Software. BlazeStack is a fully featured fire investigation case management platform that arson and fire investigators rely on to log, document, and report fire investigations. Get a free trial at blazestack.com and request a quote using the discount code STASHED. The Table Mountain Aerial Cableway has been in operation since 1929, and it moves about 80,000 people annually. It is an easy way for visitors to get to the mountain summit. I have to imagine it's quite a scenic trip as well. The modern cable cars, they hold 65 passengers each, and it transports them roughly 4,000 feet horizontally while moving 2,300 feet vertically. Table Mountain is 3,501 feet above sea level. Overall, the journey takes about 5 minutes, but it took a little longer for those folks to get down that day. The fire broke out in the lower station's parking garage where the battery energy storage system was housed. This system was integral to the cableway's operation, providing backup power to ensure functionality during outages. Apparently, they have a lot of issues with power in that area, but on this day, it became a source of chaos. Once ignited, the battery fire released thick toxic smoke filled with hazardous chemicals, as you'd expect. But it also was very difficult and challenging to extinguish because of its location. Thankfully, emergency responders arrived quickly to fight the fire. Now, while that fire was going on, there were about 400 people trapped on top of the mountain. And while some of those visitors, they waited for the cableway to resume operations, many chose to descend the mountain via the Plateclip Gorge Trail. This is a steep, tough, direct route down the mountain. And I've got some experience in the mountains, backpacking for 7 days, large elevation changes. It's not easy. You need lots of water. You need some experience, good footwear. While this trail is only 1.6 miles, it descends down roughly 2,300 feet through rough terrain, little shade. They say it takes anywhere from 1.5 to 3 hours to complete that journey if you're in decent shape. Unfortunately, not everyone who took that trail that day were prepared. And I'm not talking about just being physically capable. They would have had to have enough water, good footwear. There's a lot that goes into it. Wilderness search and rescue teams, they ended up assisting 75 tourists down the mountain. And that includes a 45-year-old injured Dutch tourist who had to be airlifted to safety. This ended up being their biggest mountain rescue effort in 64 years. The last large-scale rescue operation on Table Mountain occurred on March 27, 1960, when winds stranded 140 people on top of the mountain, requiring a 60-member team to aid in their descent. This easily could have required a much larger rescue effort. They were fortunate the flames didn't reach the cableway machinery. Had the fire spread further, it could have prolonged the crisis for 400 visitors stranded on that summit. Crews had the fire extinguished by 5 p.m., so about 4 hours, and everybody was down from the mountain by 7:30 p.m. Now, I tried to find specific details on the type of energy storage system that was installed, but I really didn't have any luck. Once you hit a certain size, you really shouldn't be installing a battery energy storage system indoors. From the videos that came out from the scene, it appears that these batteries, they weren't built into an enclosure that would stop propagation. It would be interesting to know what standard this unit was built to and if it would pass NFPA 855 or UL 9540A requirements. While battery energy storage systems do offer some benefits, incidents like these are a reminder of the potential hazard. If these types of systems are being installed, there better be a solid emergency response plan in place.